Every green room is like an AA meeting for me. And it's like, where's the coffee? Yeah. Okay, well, the green room is, you know, a place to kind of get into the mode of doing stand-up.
Because that's the energy I need to have before going on stage.
The green room is where I hide from all the people who have come to see me.
You gotta have somewhere to hide. People are scary, we're anxious, we're weird. It's just a place where you can go with other psychos and mill about.
It's also where I eat my free meal, which is the only perk of being a stand-up comedian.
Green room etiquette is tough, you know, you gotta feel the vibe.
My whole thing is don't eat my sandwich while I'm on stage.
Literally, like, could not care less about your partner. Yeah. They need to go have a seat. They could maybe come back after the show, but beforehand, this is not your place.
I'm with you.
I need water, room temp, some snacks. Yeah, because my vocal cords, I sing a lot in my bits.
F*** out of here with room temp. I either need it piping hot with some tea bags or ice cold. Room temp water makes me feel like I'm... Like I'm drinking out of a puddle or something, you know?
Sometimes you walk in, it's jovial, it's fun.
Like conversations that happen in the green room are like confessional at a Catholic church.
I like to talk, but sometimes there's people in there that, you know, I don't want to talk to.
Whatever the headliner's doing, just follow that lead.
Have ever shared a green room with a comedy hero? Yeah, Tom Segura.
I mean, I hung out at the Grand Ole Opry with Jeff Foxworthy. If I had a comedy hero, that would be it. Because I was, you know, living in a trailer park when You Might Be a Redneck came out. I was like, oh, he's talking about my life.
I mean, I guess when I was opening for Whitney Cummings on the road, I felt like, yeah, she's a comedy hero of mine.
Miss Aisha Tyler. She's talking to me like I'm people. In my head, have to not ask her personal questions about her life that I know because I've looked her up.
Jerry Seinfeld, and that was terrifying because I know everything about him, you know, and I've watched the show growing up with my family, and it's the only thing my parents have cared about.
I think we know better than to have comedy heroes by now, but I did tour with Chris Rock, and if by hang out you mean try to stay out the way, then yes.
The best green room I've ever been in.
Zany's in Nashville. We have snacks, we have drinks, we have everything back there. And then you can walk right onto the stage.
I did musical impressions on tonight's show, and I got the room that had all these bird wallpaper and a bird pillow. And it really made me happy, and good snacks.
The Cellar's green room is, and it's not a green room, which is cool. It's just a table. Food is excellent. I mean, snacks, food. I mean, obviously we have our what's important to us.
Backstage at the Opry in Nashville is also really great. They have all the snacks, and you're just kind of mingling with.
He says snacks twice.
I know. I love a snack.
The green room of Largo in LA. Two cool rooms. It's got a warm tapestry energy, and then you just never know who you'll see. It's a real cavalcade of stars.
There's a green room in Seattle that has unlimited candy, and it's in the giant chest of drawers, and each one has a different candy. It's exciting,
what?
But I think it killed Ralphie May. You got it here first, folks.
Now, could you please go watch the Stand Up Season 3? Thank you.